If he is a child, he will always want his parents to buy things for him. If he is a teenager, he will say, buy me that expensive motorcycle. Buy me this, buy me that. If she is a woman, stramonium, if she is a woman, stramonium, then she wants others to do things her own way. And if others don't do things her own way, she may become angry and hysterical. You see, she's got a lot of anger and so her intention is syphilitic. He wants things to be done her own way. And when things are not done her own way, she becomes angry and violent. If it is a child, he will say, if you don't buy me this, if you don't do this for me, to his parents, then I will hit my head to the wall. Or if it is a little child, he does this thing, he lies on the ground and knocks his head on the floor or on the wall. And if his parents, if he realizes that when he does this, at first he may do it as a game, or he may do it when he gets angry, and he may does it spontaneously, and then his parents are very worried and very scared. And when the stramonium child sees that his parents care about it and are afraid of it, then he may use it, he may to manipulate them. Whenever they don't do what he wants, he will knock his head on the floor or on the wall. Or he may pull his hair. Or he may tear his clothes, or he may bite his finger, or he may punch his head, or hit the head on the wall. That is the violence and anger to himself. But he may express his anger also by breaking things, breaking the glass of the window, breaking the glass of the door, breaking plates, breaking vases, throw things. He may throw things. He is partly controllable, hysterical, and partly uncontrollable. If he is very angry, he gets uncontrollable. And he may do things that may harm himself, or may harm others, or may break things. But at the first stage, it is a manipulative, hysterical behavior, in order others do his things his own way or do something for him. If he is a child, this is more immature and more uncontrollable. Controllable. If he is an old lady, this or a mature or an adult woman, then it will be more controllable and more hysterical. You can find Stramonium mostly with three pictures. The teenager or child that is spoiled and violent and hysterical. The adult woman that is irritable and hysterical, and the psychotic, insane, schizophrenic person that is very violent. Your schemas is a pre-psychotic or a psychotic constitution, but it is not violent because it is psori. Here we have very violent and destructive because it is syphilitic. Insane people that are very violent and self-destructive and destructive in general are frequently stramonium influenced by stramonium constitution. You see a child that is very angry, very unobedient, very wanting this and that, and demanding it straightly. If you don't do what I want, I will break that vase. I will hit my head on the wall. And so on. This is the essence of Stramonium and the psychological profile of Stramonium. Let's go on. Let's talk about Kina. The essence of Kina. Kina is mostly a child remedy. Rarely you can find it to adults. It is this. The essence of Kina is the strong head, strong-headed, stubborn to the extremes, syphilitic. The syphilitic, stubborn, strong-headed child. Let's see this. Syphilitic. Strong-headed. Syphilitic, stubborn. Egoistic. Self-centered. Not vain, it's not vain, it's strong-headed, it's stubborn. If he fixes his will on something, then he will not leave it. You may shout at him if it is a child, you may threaten it. You may hit it, it won't go back. It won't go a step back. The mother tells the child, don't touch that vase, you will break it. He will look at her and do this. Don't do it, I tell you. I will hit you. The mother gets furious. He may punish him, hit him. Then he may again do it. Or when his mother isn't around, at cold blood, he will go and break the vase. He is very stubborn. The parents of Kina child are desperate. They don't know what to do with him. It is mostly a male child, but you can also find female children. So very stubborn, very not giving up, and you don't like a Kina child. It is so strong-headed, irritable. When parents or others don't do things like he wants, a Kina child has this sensitivity to the nose, to the inside of the nose, and he keeps picking inside, on the inside of the nose. Not when a child is having a coryza, nose secretions, and he tries to get it out. In normal conditions, at the state of clinical health, he has this tendency to pick inside the nose all the time. A strong-headed, stubborn, syphilitic, demanding, angry, easily irritable child. Now let's go to anagardium. We can learn much from anagardium, as Kent says, and he is right. We can learn much about the human nature. Let me tell you what do I mean by that before we analyze anagardium. Here is the man. Let me remind you of the structure. And levels of man and universe. We have the several levels, that is, we have the physical body, the etheric body or vital force, the soul or psychological level, and the spirit. Spirit, soul, vital force, body, material body. As we have analyzed in previous lessons, we have the intellectual psyche, the sensation psyche, the conscience psyche. The conscience psyche, now let me also do the universe. We have man, we have the universe. Man, universe. We have the the same levels, that is, we have the spiritual world . We have the higher psychological world or psychic world, the lower psychic world, the etheric world, and the material world. This is the world of uniqueness, and this is the world of duality or world of diversity. Here you have love and hate, wrong and correct, good and bad. Here you have only one dimension, only good, only love, spiritual love. So, our conscience, the higher body, the higher level of soul, our conscience and spirit connect us with the higher psychological world and the spiritual world, that is, with the world of uniqueness. Our lower levels, the intellectual soul, the sensation soul, the vital force and the body connect us with the lower existence of ours, with the world of diversity or duality, with the lower psychological world, psychic world, with the etheric world and the material world. So there are two kinds of the level that decides where do we go up or down is the intellectual psyche. We have free will, we are not animals, so we can decide whether to go up or down, to do the good thing or the bad thing. And this kind of will that connects us to the spiritual world, and is when our intellectual soul is tuned with the conscience and the spirit, then this is the internal will. The internal will, the higher will, the will that is not selfish, internal will. This is the internal will, the not selfish one, and this is the external will. This is the internal self, and this is the external self. So, all people have the conscience as part of their soul, the higher part of their soul, all people. Conscience is the spirit, is the drop of God inside us, is our higher self. All people have inside their conscience, it's the gift of God to human beings. But not all people hear the voice and obey the voice of their conscience. There is no such thing as a person that does not have conscience. He has a conscience, but he doesn't want to hear the voice of his conscience, because he has become very egoistic, very focused on the world of diversity, not focused on the world of uniqueness. Kant called this external will or bad will, and this internal will. Or he said that we have two wills, the bad will and the good will. What does that have to do with homeopathy and with an Agardian constitution? We have two kinds of Anagardium constitutions. When the Anagardium constitution, we have one constitution, Anagardium, but if it influences a psoric person, then we have another version of Anagardium clinical picture of Anagardium chronic illness, and a different version if we have Anagardium constitution influencing a syphilitic individual, then we have a different picture. So now let's go to Anagardium and see what happens. You see how important it is to discriminate between the constitution, the constitutional influence, the man, the individual that is being influenced by the constitution. So, the essence of Anagardium is that he may be syphilitic or psoric, and that he has a great influence by an evil external will. He is influenced by an evil external will that gives him evil thoughts that drive him to evil actions, that may drive him to evil actions. If we have a syphilitic background, then we have the syphilitic version of the constitutional Anagardium picture. We have a person that has evil thoughts, his conscience is not consulted, he doesn't want to hear his conscience, and then he does evil actions. Let me complete here that he believes that he has the idea that he is very smart. You see, focusing on smartness, on power, on authority, on manipulating others, on money, because money is power, is syphilitic evil things. So, we have a person that has evil thoughts, he doesn't hear his conscience, and he does evil actions when he is syphilitic. How can you find this? How can you ask and find this at an individual? Because he is smart, he will not easily reveal what happens to him. Because he has learned that if you say these evil tendencies that you have to others, the society will go against you. So he will tell you, if you ask him in a proper way, that when he was a child, he was doing harsh practical jokes. He was doing hard practical jokes and he was happy. He got joy by doing it, by hurting other people, because he was confirming to himself that he is smart. He is smarter than others. So he can play practical jokes to them and enjoy the result, the pain of the other. Enjoy that others are so stupid, so silly, that he is above them. That others can't play practical jokes to him because he is very smart and he understands, realizes what happens. What can a child do? You will see that small child, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 years old, and he has this grandfather that is very old and he doesn't walk well and he doesn't see well, and the Anagarbian child puts an obstacle in his way in order, or the outside of the banana in order to step on it, his grandfather fall down, hit his head, weep and shout or get angry, and then he enjoys it and laughs, as if he has no conscience, as if he has no love, as if he doesn't realize what he's doing. And the mother and father shout at him and hit him, but it is as if he doesn't understand that he has done something wrong, as if he doesn't care that he has done something wrong, as if he doesn't have a conscience. As if he is not aware of what is good and what is bad. And he doesn't have guiltiness. He's not guilty after what he does. He doesn't have any remorse. And he doesn't apologize. And he does it again. Or he may torture the weak ones. He is at school and he is that cruel child that does very cruel practical jokes to other children, and he laughs, he enjoys laughing. Or he does practical jokes to the teacher, hard ones, cruel ones, to pain him, to harm him, and then he laughs about it and he's proud about what he did. He may not say it if he is to be punished, but he is proud about it, or he doesn't feel bad about it. He may hit other children. He may push other children and they fell down and hit and cry, and he laughs. He may do cruel practical jokes, or he may torture animals, the weak animals. Torture the cat, hit the cat or the dog, take a scissor, pair of scissors, and cut the tail of the cat, or set fire to the cat. This is the syphilitic Anagardian case where the person seems as if he is very evil, as if he is possessed by the evil spirits. He considers himself very smart and he wants all the time to have authority to control others, but not as a Lachesis constitution individual, but in order to, because he is smart and he wants to control things, and because he enjoys confirming by his behavior that others are stupid and he is smart. When we have to do with a psoric individual, an individual that has a psoric background and has moral principles and has been educated with some morality and ethics through religion, through his parental teachings and so on, then things are different. Then he starts having these evil thoughts, and on having these thoughts, his conscience reacts. He hears the voice of his conscience. He hears, he thinks of his moral principles and religious principles and his morality, and he says, what on earth is happening to me? How can I have such bad thoughts? He feels bad about it. He feels awful about it. He starts blaming himself. He starts feeling guilty and awful about it, because he has two wills, the external will and external self, the evil one, and the internal will, the good one, that tells him, what are you thinking of? What are you going to do? So, as Kant says characteristically, the psoric Anagardium individual feels as if he has two wills, and a demon on one shoulder or on one ear telling him, do that bad thing, and an angel on the other shoulder or ear. Remember those cartoons that the star of the cartoon has a demon and an angel, and the one tells him, do this, be cruel, be powerful, no mercy, and you are smart, you are the one. And the angel tells him, what are you going to do? You are going to harm people. What are you going to do? Or he may think that demons and Satan tells him to start cursing God and religion, start cursing his parents and doing bad things. While on the other hand, his goodwill tells him, you are the child of God. What are you doing there? You are harming people that love you, that haven't done anything. And so this is a very agonizing and full of anxiety situation. Most of the times, or all the times, he doesn't do bad things. He is suffering by trying to avoid doing these things that his mind, his external will tells him, and he feels guilty and awful about it. One will, two wills. You see how important it is to know the miasmatic influences of the individual, and how these miasmatic influences define the final tint of the constitution, or the version of the constitution. We have talked about the psoric sulfur and this psychotic sulfur. We have talked about the psoric valeriana and the syphilitic valeriana, the psoric platina and the syphilitic platina, and so on. But in Anagardium, we have this great difference between the psoric version of the Anagardium and the syphilitic version of the Anagardium. Anagardium is a very rare constitution, although we live in a syphilitic era. Very rare to see, because it is rare, it is an extreme condition, and the syphilitic Anagardium doesn't go to the doctor easily. I try to give you the essence and the main psychological profile of Pulsatilla, Calcarea Carbonica, Stramonium, Kina, and Anagardium. You will read the rest of the details to the classical miasmatic constitutional materia medica. Thank you.